The Child's Shadow. The child's shadow woke up one morning when the child jumped out of bed to go to the potty. The shadow didn't want to get out of bed to potty because it felt sleepy and wanted to stay curled up on the pillow. But it couldn't because it had to follow wherever the child went. So it sat on its shadow potty, then washed its shadow hands in the shadow soapy sink water. Then it sat at the table and ate shadow toasted bread and strawberry jelly. It didn't like strawberry jelly, it liked grape jelly. But it had to eat strawberry anyway because the shadow had to do everything just like the child. "I want to do what I want to do," the shadow said in shadow words that nobody could hear. Children are so lucky and so happy because they can always do everything they want to and exactly what they want to, when they want to, and it's not fair. The shadow wasn't very smart saying that because it didn't know very much about grown-ups. That day, the shadow had to sit still in a shadow desk chair at school and got bored fast. And when a bigger child pushed the child, and the child banged a knee hard on the floor, the shadow had to bang its shadow knee hard too, and that hurt. And when the child talked in class during quiet time, and the teacher looked mean and wagged a finger, but the shadow teacher got even angrier and looked even meaner and wagged her finger even harder and longer. Finally, the child and shadow got home and played zoo with some little toy animals and had supper and then went to bed. But the shadow wasn't even tired and didn't want to go to bed, but had to. It just didn't seem fair. And then the light went out. And then it was dark everywhere. And then the shadow noticed the light wasn't there to make it stick to the child. The shadow was free. It could go anywhere it wanted. And all night long, as the child slept, the shadow rode the shadow tricycle and banged loud on a shadow box for a drum and chased and teased the shadow cat and played with shadow boats in the tub and splashed shadow water everywhere and didn't even care. And ate so many shadow cookies, its shadow tummy had a little tummy ache. Finally, the shadow felt tired. It could have laid down anywhere it wanted, but it felt just a little bit lonesome and decided to lay down in bed again, snug and tight beside the child. And before long, when the shadow went to sleep, nobody could see, but in the dark, it had on its little shadow face the happiest shadow smile you never did see. Read by Rahima Johnson. Copyright 2015.